Only I could have stopped Kay before she went out, but I couldn't. So now she's out there in this blizzard, alone, pregnant. I mean, she could be dying, Sam.
Grace, listen, don't even say that, right? We have to believe that Kay and her baby will both be all right.
But you know, you found her scarf in the blood, in the snow.
Hey, it doesn't mean that she's hurt. It could just be a coincidence.
She's been gone so long, Sam.
That's why I called in the state troopers to help search for her. Okay, but because of the storm, all the emergency services are short of manpower.
All right, well, you know what? I'm just going to go out there myself and start looking for her.
Look, if I would have been home instead of over at the Crane Mansion dealing with Teresa evicting Ivy, I could have stopped Kay from leaving this house. Now, I'm going to get back out there myself and search for my daughter until I find her.
Oh, God. Please let my daughter be all right. I don't know what I'd do if anything happened to her or her baby.
If Kay is dead, then Sam and Grace are going to cling together in their grief. And everything we've done, all of our hard work to drive that wedge, will be forgotten. Oh, that knocked-up brat had better be alive somewhere. Because if she's not, then we're back to square one in trying to break up Sam and Grace.
You're all hot, Ivy, aren't you? Hoping a confused young girl isn't dead simply because a death would muck up your plans. Dare I ask what demented thought just entered that twisted mind of yours?
Well, I just thought if Kay is dead, we might be able to use it to make Sam blame Grace for driving his daughter away. Kay's death could still be the thing that breaks up Sam and Grace forever.
If Dad and Chief Bennett can't find Kay, maybe putting out word on the net will help.
You know, my sister and I, we have our differences, but I would never wish anything bad on Kay.
Please, God, help us find Kay. And until we do, please keep her safe from harm. Oh, I have the worst feeling that wherever Kay is, she's in terrible danger.
Open the door and go to your death.
Tabitha, I'm not so sure it's safe for me to go into your basement.
Why have a lot?
You know, the way your water heater's rumbling, it could explode at any minute. Since you're a witch, can't you just wiggle your nose and fix it?
I told you, dear, I'm not a witch.
Please. I know what I saw.
Grace was right all along. Tabitha really is a witch. I hit my head hard with my son. Now I'm just hallucinating right now.
What the?
I'm not hallucinating. Tabitha is definitely a witch.
Reese was right. You're a sorceress posing as an eccentric old lady.
I'm not.
R2. And once I go down and get that sleeping bag that you're loaning me, I'm going to tell everyone the truth, that you're a bona fide witch.
Foolish girl. You're not going to tell anyone anything. Once you go down there, you're going to go up in flames.
Expecting you.
Yes. Then pay up the 6 months back rent you owe me or get out.
I'm out of dough. I lost it at the races. On a nag named Ivy.
I could care less. Just cough up the cash or get out.
It's snowing out there. You can't evict me on a night like this.
Well, give me one good reason not to.
I'll do anything you want, anything. Just don't put me out into the cold.
Oh, you'll do anything, huh?
Anything you want. Just tell me, and I'll give it to you.
Here's a hint. So, do you think you're, up to the job?
You'll find that I'm a very hard worker.
I've made my decision as to whether or not I should give Antonio the experimental drug cocktail. Please. Tell us what you've decided, Sheridan.
Okay, what's going on with Antonio? Hank just called me, said that there's a drug that could save his life, and it's up to you if he gets it or not.
Yeah, well, Sheridan was just about to tell us what she's decided.
Oh, okay, Sheridan. Are you going to tell Dr. Russell to give him the drug or not?
I would hold the hand of the one who could lead me places, and kiss the lips of the one who could sing so sweet.
She's in terrible danger. Please, God, give me a way to help Kay. Help me find her so I can save her before it's too late. Kay. Must find Kay.
Charity?
You all right?
Kay. Must find Kay. Save her.
Oh, the shame, the humiliation.
And don't forget frustration. You know, I have needs, too.
I'm sorry, my pet. This is the first time this has ever happened to me.
Which is a very good thing I am not really the landlady, or else you'd be out on the street for falling down on the job.
This is all Teresa's fault.
Why, what'd she do, hide your Viagra?
Stop thinking about it.
Oh, thanks a lot.
No. I mean that she's always up to something. Like tonight, she actually succeeded in evicting Ivy from the premises. A feat for which I'll ever be grateful, but that's beside the point. I can't help but wonder what that little power monger is up to next. I mean, it's obvious Teresa wants the whole crane, kit, and caboodle, my house, my money, control the family empire. Because of her threat to my very existence, the Crane. Teresa's robbed me of my manhood.
Well, at this point, it would just be petty theft.
Teresa must be stopped.
What? That's what I've been working on.
Oh, right. This mystery man who claims he has information that will get rid of Teresa forever.
Yeah, and finally put an end to the reign of Teresa the Terrible.
What if this man is just some sort of con? What if he's telling you what you want to hear just to get the money?
Well, at this point, that's just a chance we're going to have to take, because we cannot endure another flop like tonight.
You're right. We must rid ourselves of Teresa once and for all.
Sheridan, tell us what you have decided about Antonio.
Sheridan made her decision?
Yeah, she's about to tell us right now.
This is the most difficult decision I've ever had to make.
All right, I want to do what's right. But I also want to do what's best for Antonio. Now, I have thought about this, and I have prayed about it. And if Eve could guarantee me that giving Antonio the drug would both save his life and cure him, I wouldn't hesitate to do it. But Eve has warned us that the chances are greater that the drug won't cure Antonio. It'll just put him in a coma or he'll become a vegetable. What are you saying exactly? I know that giving Antonio the drug will help him live longer. But I have searched my heart and my soul, and I have questioned whether Antonio would want the kind of existence that having the drug might give him. So after praying to God for guidance and thinking long and hard about what Antonio would want, I think I've come to the right decision. I've decided...
Wait, stop!
Mama, please.
No. Before you tell us what you've decided, there's something I have to say as Antonio's mother.
Charity's the coffee ready? David and I are ready to go back out. Charity.
No, you all right? Why isn't she answering me?
I think she's having a premonition.
Another one? How often does this sort of weirdness happen around here?
You better hope Charity's premonition isn't how far you'd go to get Sam.
She still hasn't snapped out of it.
Out of what?
One minute Charity was fine, then she kind of glazed over and started mumbling about finding Kay.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think we should let her go. Maybe they'll find her dead in a snowdrift.
Now, hang on a second. You can't let her go out in this weather.
Oh, don't we have to? She might lead us to where Kay is.
I'll go with her.
Yeah, I'm going too.
We'll all go.
We'll all go.
Can you believe these people? They'll follow this whacked out girl as if she's magically going to lead them to Kay.
Tabitha, this is ridiculous.
For me to have to go down into a dark basement to look for a sleeping bag? What if it's way up high on a shelf and I can't even see it? Now, I mean, I'm still a little woozy from hitting my head, and I know you're a witch, so can't you just make it materialize or something?
Hey, I told you.
Yeah, you're not a witch, right?
Precisely. Now then, come on, down you go.
Come on. You and I both know the truth, so just snap your fingers and make it materialize.
I can't do that, dear. If you want that sleeping bag, you're going to have to go down in the basement and get it yourself.
Okay, fine. Deny the truth. But since I'm still not feeling well, if something happens to me, I want you to know it'll be your fault.
Something's definitely going to happen to you, dear. You're never going to leave that basement alive.
What is it, Pilar? What do you want to say?
Antonio may be your husband, but he's also my son. My firstborn son, a son that I cannot bear the thought of losing again.
Again?
When Antonio left home so suddenly and mysteriously all those years ago, it was like a knife through my heart. Days turned into weeks, months, and finally years. Others stopped believing that Antonio would come home, but I did not. I held on to my hope and my faith that God would bring him back home to me. I lit a candle every night for my son, praying for his safe return. I never wavered in my belief that he would come back to me. And he did. A mother never gives up on a child. Never. Even now, when Eve is telling us that his chances are not great, that even with this drug that could keep him alive, it won't necessarily cure him, but there is still hope. And we cannot deny my son the life that God has given him when there's still a chance that he could live. Now, I know that there are risks. I know. But I also know that my faith will help Antonio through this, the same way my faith brought him back home to me. Now, this drug is my son's only chance. So please, give him this drug, because without it, he will die. Please do the right thing for my son. Please. to not withhold the drug that could... the drug that could save his life.
Would you stop pacing and eat another oyster?
I've already had a dozen.
Well, I haven't had any. So come on, come on, over here, come on. Here. Do you feel anything?
No.
Oh. Okay, here. What about now?
Nothing. Little Julian is still little.
Oh, this is so frustrating.
I must rid myself of Teresa post-haste.
That is not what I am talking about.
But Teresa is the root of our problem.
You're just figuring this out now? Little Tacosita has been the bane of Ivy's in my existence ever since she set her sights on Ethan. Oh, we've tried to get rid of her more than once, but that girl has more comebacks in her than Liza Minnelli. And boy, can she carry a grudge. I mean, all Ivy and I did was make a few little harmless comments about little Ethan and her family, and then she just tossed Ivy out into the cold. And if it hadn't been for you, she would have tossed me out as well.
Well, she can't throw me out. This is my home.
At least for now.
What do you mean by that?
Well, given Teresa's special relationship with Alistair, she may be going after you next.
Egad. You may have a point. So strange. Her father seems to do everything Teresa wants. It's as if he's her guardian angel. He saved her from being executed. Gave her a high-ranking position at Crane Industries. He didn't stop her when she rehired Ethan into the family business.
If you're not careful, Alistair could give Teresa this house free and clear.
Nothing is free and clear with Father.
Look, all I'm saying is that we have to get rid of Teresa now before she causes any more damage to your life. Now, here. Nothing?
Alas, little Julian is still in repose. It's all Teresa's fault. You're right. Enough is enough. If my wife continues at this rate, I'll end up with nothing at all.
And I'll have to resort to chasing after the pool boy. Just kidding. I meant the stable boy.
Must find Kay. Must save her.
Charity?
Sorry, Kay, but I can't let you blow my cover. It's time for you to broil till done for.
Kay. I found you, Kay.
Hell's bells. That wretched blondie do-gooder is ruining things for me again.
I know that the chance of my son being cured is small. But I don't care. I beg you to please give my son that chance, no matter what the odds are against him.
I considered that.
Sheridan, I have known you your entire life. I've been like a mother to you since your mother, Catherine, died.
Yes, you have. I love you for it.
So please, please, do not repay me by taking my son's life away.
Mama. You stop trying to guilt Sheridan into doing what you want. It's not fair to her.
This is not about Sheridan. This is about Antonio and what's fair to him. I know that you love Luis. And I know that you and he want to be together. But you cannot decide Antonio's fate based on your love for his brother. If you let Antonio die because you want to be with Luis, because you know that his death would make it easier for you and he to be together, then you will be guilty of murder. Antonio's murder. And I will disown both you and Luis forever.
I can't believe what passes for normal in Grace's family. I mean, Charity just walked out of here like she was an extra in The Night of the Living Dead, and everyone acts like it's business as usual. What am I saying? This is Hell House. It is business as usual. You know, birds attack this place. The walls dripped blood. The closets, portals to hell. And on slow nights, house-wrecking demons come and suck this place into the bowels of the earth. Merciful heaven! I am doing Sam a huge favor by taking him out of this madhouse.
Well, altruism is your forte, Ivy.
Seriously, David. No, I am saving Sam from this bunch of lunatics, and when we're together, he's going to thank me for giving him a normal life.
I hardly think life with you would ever be normal. Besides, you're not doing any of this for Sam. You're breaking up his marriage, and you're destroying his family for one reason and one reason only. You want Sam for yourself.
And you want Grace. We're even.
Unconscionable is more like it.
Oh, please, David, save me another bout of conscience. You want Grace, and you will do whatever it takes to get her. You might not like it, but you'll do it until the Bennets are bust, and Grace is yours. Forever.
Charity, what are you doing here? Hello? I asked you a question. Kay, we've been looking all over for you.
Oh, well, what luck. You found me.
We're Tabitha's.
Indeed you are, dear.
Weird.
And the smoke and the glow are something to do with the plants I'm growing in my basement. And as for the rumbling noise, I was just telling Kay that...
No, it's just so weird. I was just at Aunt Grace's and I had this premonition that Kay was in trouble, and then I somehow ended up here.
But Kay isn't in trouble. As you can see, she's perfectly fine.
Kay, sweetheart, you're okay. Oh, thank God.
Kay, honey.
Oh, my God. Father, we thought you were lost in the snow.
Injured, maybe even worse.
Oh, I'm sorry. You lambs were all so upset. I was just going to call you and tell you that Kay was here when Charity wandered in.
Charity, thanks for helping us, Spiner.
Oh, no, it was just God answering my prayers.
Name dropper.
I think I should maybe sit down.
Oh, sweetie, here's a chair.
Honey, you're hurt. You know, I think we should get you to the doctor. Jess, would you call Eve?
No, I'm fine, really. I hit my head when I fell in the snow, and it's not even bleeding anymore, so I'm fine.
Oh, honey, you had us scared to death. We found your scarf in the snow and your good bit of blood. We thought that you'd passed out somewhere and die from exposure before we'd find you.
Oh, it's such a relief to see that you're okay.
Yeah, I'll say.
I think we should get you home and into bed.
That's a good idea.
I'm not going home, Mother. Not now, and not ever.
Pilar, I know you're upset about Antonio, but you cannot accuse Sheridan of murder.
If you deny my son the medication to live so that you can be with his brother, it will be
murder.
Cold-blooded murder.
I don't know what to say.
No, I do. Mama, you've got to stop this. You can't accuse Sheridan of plotting murder when she's just trying to do what's best for Antonio.
To knowingly take someone's life is murder, Luis. And if Sheridan refuses to let Eve give my son that drug, she knows what will happen. Antonio will die.
Mama, you saw the tape. Antonio said that he did not want to become a vegetable, and that could happen if she gives him the drug.
Your love for Sheridan is blinding you, mijo. To not give Antonio this drug would be the same thing as shooting him, because Sheridan wanted out of her marriage so that she could be with you. How could I ever look at either one of you again, knowing that because of your desire for each other, you denied my son the chance to live? You would be no different than Cain, the killer of his brother Abel.
You gotta stop pressuring Sheridan like this.
I told you, this is not about Sheridan. This is about my son. It is my duty as a mother to protect my child, and I swear to God I will protect him, no matter what price I have to pay to see that he has a chance to live. Please. Please give my son that chance. Don't do this, Sheridan. Don't do this. Or you will have Antonio's death on your hands.
Okay, now, I know you're upset over what happened tonight. And I'm sure both you and your mother said some things that you didn't mean. But once you get a good night's sleep, things will look so bleak in the morning, okay? We'll work things out with a nice, long talk over breakfast.
Daddy, I told you I'm not coming home. Ever.
Okay, honey, listen, we're all very tired, and we need some sleep. Just
Dad,
come home tonight with us.
I'm not coming home. And I am of legal age, so you can't make me come with you.
I know. It's just that your mother and I would really like you to come home with us tonight.
I know you do. But she doesn't.
Okay, please.
I am not coming home. And that's all there is to it, okay?
So where are you gonna stay?
I'll find a place.
I'm sure you will. But as corny as it sounds, there really is no place like home.
Yeah, well, that's kind of what I'm hoping.
Sweetheart, listen, I know things have been difficult, okay? But don't make things harder by going it alone, right? We're here for you. We love you, and we want to help you.
Okay, we're family. No, we're not going to lie to you.
Your mom is right, honey.
Dad, how can you possibly be that naive? Everything around us is a pack of lies.
What are you talking about?
People aren't what they seem. And they're keeping secrets. Big secrets. But I know the truth. I know the whole shocking truth.
Forget all about Teresa. Just concentrate on little Julian. Now think hard, Pookie. Hard. Excuse me. Hello?
I have the information you want on Teresa.
And you're sure you have absolute proof?
Positive, but it's going to cost you.
How much?
$1 million.
I'll see what I can do.
$1 million bucks. Take it or leave it.
All right, I'll get you the cash. I'll be back in touch soon.
I gather that was your man with the dirt on Teresa?
Yes. He guarantees it will bury her.
Good. How much does he want?
Well, not very much when you consider what you're getting in return.
But how much?
Well, it's vendetta value for your vendetta dollar.
How much?
$1 million.
$1 million? That is outrageous and out of the question.
Pookie, it...
Do you think I'm made of money?
Well, yeah, I mean, you are a crane. Well, at least for the time being.
Excuse me?
Pookie, if you let Teresa get away with this, she might try to take that away from you, too.
There must be something else that we can do for Antonio. A specialist that we can call in on head injuries, or another treatment that can save his life without tearing our family apart. Now, I will use all the crane money and power I can to find it.
Teresa, thank you for offering me her. But your brother's time is running out. Sheridan can either let your brother die or give Eve consent to give him this experimental drug. It's Antonio's only hope. His fate and his life is in Sheridan's hands now.
Mama, you don't really mean what you said to Luis and Sheridan, do you?
Yes, I do. If Antonio's left to die, Luis and Sheridan will be dead to me.
What is Sheridan going to do?
If she honors Antonio's wish to die with dignity and not be a burden, Pilar will never forgive her.
Oh, God. I'm really sorry you had to hear that. My mother just... she's so upset and so worried, she can't look at all sides of this.
I know. I understand. I really do.
Well, I don't know what you decided to do, but... whatever it is, don't let her change your mind, okay? You just stick to it.
I won't.
Sharon, I'll support you, whatever you decide. Now, even if it does cost me my family.
Excuse me, Dr. Russell just called. She's on her way with the experimental drug cocktail for Antonio. She wants to know whether you've decided to use it or not. Yes. I've decided.
David, come on. We're both going to get what we want. You're going to have Grace, I'm going to have Sam, and no one is going to be the wiser.
I wouldn't be too sure about that.
Why not?
Because of Kay.
Well, if she's dead, then we don't have to worry about her now, do we?
Okay, for God's sake.
No, we don't even know that Kay has a clue that we're working together.
Have you forgotten about the party Teresa threw at the seascape? Kay was on the brink of exposing us.
No, I think that if Kay really knew about us, she would have said something to Sam, no matter what I did to try to stop her. And she hasn't. I think we're safe.
Okay. We are vulnerable, you are delusional, and Kay is devious. She may be waiting to tell what she knows when it would do the most damage.
Well, if that's true, then I hope something bad really has happened to Kay. Because if she knows about us, and if she has said anything to anybody, we are finished. Grace will never speak to you again. John will never forgive you. And worst of all, Sam would hate me forever.
What do you mean people are keeping secrets? Who's keeping secrets?
Damn it, David. I hired you to break up Sam and Grace. Now just do it.
You know, I'm sick and tired of being threatened by you, Ivy.
It's not a threat, David. If you don't do what I hired you to do, I will tell everyone about your past, and we both know that that's not a pretty picture.
You don't have to remind me about my past.
Won't everyone be surprised when they find out that you're not married to Grace, and that John isn't Grace's son, and that you lied about the whole thing? What?
Answer me, Kay. Who's keeping secrets?
Well, for starters, David and Ivy, they're working together to try to tear apart your marriage.
What?
It's all a lie, Dad. David isn't Mom's husband. John isn't her son. It's all just a big, fat lie.
Well, your alleged informant wants $1 million before he'll give us the goods on Teresa. That is highway robbery.
Oh, come on, Pookie. $1 million is pocket change to a mega billionaire like you.
Au contraire, my sweet. $1 million is $1 million to anyone, even a nouveau riche nerd like Bill Gates.
Well, I guess it just all depends on
how badly you want to get rid of Teresa and how much you want to replace your wife with more, pleasurable things.
Well, all right, I'll pay the money. Anything to get Teresa out of this house.
Well, I knew you'd see reason.
Wait, what are you doing?
Oh, I'm calling your personal banker. I'm sure my source would like cash.
This had better work. I must get up and running again.
Sheridan. You sure about your decision?
Yes, I'm sure. I've made my decision. And this is my decision. No, I've listened to what everyone had to say. I listened to Eve. I listened to you, Pilar. And I listened to what Antonio had to say on that videotape. But in the end, I listened to my heart of hearts. And I let it and God be my guide. Tell Dr. Russell I want to go ahead with the treatment.
Oh, okay. Gracias a Dios.
I want Antonio to have the drug. I want him to have a chance to live.
I think Luis just lost on Sheridan for good.
Not condone you treating my flesh and blood the way that you've treated my mother.
Be strong. Hold on. And have faith.
Please.
It's okay. I'm right here.